Hi, this is Brett Hotz, and I'm going to provide to you an overview of Sage 300 CRE, otherwise known as Timberline software. Sage 300 CRE is a very comprehensive, full-featured job cost accounting project management system. The modules range from typical accounting items that you would have in a contractor's office, job cost, and so forth, as well as a full payroll with the ability to do multi-state payroll, union payrolls, certified wage reporting, ACA reporting, direct deposit, and so on. For those of you that are specialty contractors that do work order style work, there's a service work order module available also. This is the main desktop. So when you sign in, you're going to have a list of applications that you have access to. You will have access to a dashboard that's a crystal report design. I have an example that is one that is geared towards an owner to provide them an overview of where things are at in their company. High-level job information, payables, receivables, bank account information, and these blue items are sublinks that could drill into details. So it'll open up a subreport that can be drilled into to look at additional information, and so on. Here's another dashboard that's geared more towards a financial manager that, again, similar information, but different. In addition to having a full list of all the modules in the system, you can build a favorites list of things that you use all the time, such as inquiries and reports. Those are the two main ways, in addition to the desktop dashboard, to get information out of the system. So if I wanted to look at perhaps a log of all the subcontracts, I could click on this inquiry, me being Justin, and it would pull up a list of subcontracts and details of them. I can see my estimated cost for the subcontract. It looks like we're running a little bit over on this one. We've committed more than that. That's what's been invoiced. That's what's been paid. And when we drill into that, we can see all the details below that. So very nice drillable inquiries available, as well as reports. And reports can be, again, accounting reports, job cost reports. There's about 1,600 reports that come with the system. This is a very typical WIP style report. I'm just going to leave the cutoff date as 02/28/23. And when we click a print preview, we can see the particular projects we have, costs and billing in excess, and this could be saved to PDF or saved to Excel also. Reports can also be written in Excel, and this is an example of a cost to complete worksheet. So when the report runs, it fills in all the blanks, and this particular report is designed where a project manager or a person responsible for updating a cost to complete forecast would type that in right there. So let's move on and talk a little bit more about routine things that a person would do in the system, starting with setting up jobs and so forth. So typical workflow would be setting up a job, putting in budget, schedule values, writing commitments, which are POs and subcontracts, the ability to input change requests, turn those into change orders, as well as owner change orders, and commitment change orders are all right here. So I'm going to just pull up Job Central here, and I'm just going to show a job setup wizard. So this is where you would go to set up a project. So you type in, you can have the job numbers various ways here. Sage 300 CRE is a multi-entity system. So in this case, you can see that we have several different EINs or business balance sheet entities. We can define for payroll what state it in. If we have local jurisdictional taxes like City of St. Louis or City of Kansas City, those can be input here. This happens to be a certified job. We're telling the system who the customer is. We're setting this up as a progress style bill with 10% retainage. What type of a billing format? We're going to do landscape detailed with stored materials. This screen here is where we could type in our schedule values, or this could be pulled in from a spreadsheet, essentially four columns here to get that information in. So in this case, we have just three items. If I was going to put an additional item on here, I'll just type one in real quick. And we'll say that the masonry section is $400,000. As far as how we're going to set up the job cost codes, again, this can come from Sage Estimating, or this can be imported from a spreadsheet. And the format of it is pretty straightforward. It's just the cost code, the cost category, if there's any unit costs, and dollar amounts. So very easy to set that up to. If we were to put in a new subcontract or new purchase order, we would just click New Commitments. And we could just call that up. I'm going to bring up an existing one for the sake of time here. Lists can be sorted different ways. I'm just going to bring it up, sort it by job. And I want to bring up a subcontract from job number 2 here. So let's say it's the framing materials subcontract. Or in this case, it's a purchase order. These are the cost code items and the items below. There is a full compliance system that's part of the Sage 300 CRE system, so that in here we could put insurance, work comp, so forth, that's supposed to be tracked on this particular subcontract, and the system will warn you if those have expired. You can email directly out of the system from here. The format of the POs, subcontracts, and so forth are crystal report designs, which can be modified by you, or Bangert Inc. can provide assistance in creating your own personalized ones. As far as what a change request looks like, again, pretty straightforward. I'm just going to bring up a change request screen here. And we're on the office park job, and I'm going to bring up this one right here. It's a potential change request. Again, we could create a new one here. I'm just going to open up one that's in the system already. So this is where we put the details for it. Special job specific items that you will pay us for. Down below here, we would specify and price out. In this case, it's demo that has labor and material. And then down below here, we have markups for that. So our total costs are $1,000, our marked up price is $3,300, and we could email that directly out of the system here. We would also update directly from the change request the cost budget for the job estimate. And if we wanted to see what that looked like, we could print preview it right here. And again, this is a crystal report design that can be edited and tailored to your specifications. So it just takes a minute to pull up. And of course, your logo and so forth. Again, this is just one version that ships with the system. So this is all about that job setup, schedule values, budget, and so forth. As far as accounts payable goes, very straightforward process, entering AP invoices to pay, select invoices to pay, print checks, or do ACH. The system can also produce lien waivers if needed. So again, if I open up this enter invoices screen, very straightforward. And along with that, I'm going to resize the screen here a little bit. I would be able to bring up the vendor. So I have something in here from A1 Electric. It looks like they're out of compliance on their insurance. So let's go look at those details. It looks like all these insurances have been expired. And if I click compliance management, that would take us into the compliance management system. And we could look at all of the compliance items for A1 Electric. Or we could look at that just for a specific job. So let's go ahead and put in an AP invoice in to pay. Let's say we have one in here for $5,000. Miscellaneous job purchases. We're going to say that this is a February expense. If we wanted to code this to March, we would just put in a March accounting date. Here's where we're going to match it up against an open purchase order for this particular vendor. Again, I'm getting a compliance warning here. I'm going to override that. That can be limited to different individuals. The system's telling me we haven't rolled into this accounting month. Is that okay? I'm going to say yes. And what you'll see here is that our invoice is $5,000, but it's only pre-filling with $1,800. Why? Because that's the amount of the what's been issued on the purchase order. If I would go to override that, I'll get a warning that's going to tell me we're going to go over. This warning can be a soft warning such as this, or it can be a hard warning where it prevents you from entering that information. So again, we just entered that invoice and it's in the system now. As far as selecting invoices to pay, that's this item right here. So again, we select this item right here. And it's going to give me a list of all the open payables that we have out there based on a filter. So we could say everything that's due before 2/28/23. I want to sort that by job. And now you're going to see all the items job by job. So the Northwest Food Warehouse, the red H, I have some items on hold. I have all kinds of compliance issues here, so I need to go down through here and review these before we make any payments. As far as selecting items for payment, you can fully pay something. In this case, we have a discount due, or you can partial pay something by tapping the little partial pay box and say we're going to pay $100 of that invoice, and we're going to put a memo on that payment so that the vendor calls us. Call me for your payment. So very interactive, very easy to update and do. As I mentioned earlier, there's also a full payroll module that supports union payroll as well as multi-state. You can enter time directly into the payroll module via the enter time screen. For those of you that have a remote payroll time needs, there are a variety of options, whether it's Sage Field Operations and other third-party vendors that you can also use for time capture. But let's say that I had manual timesheets coming in from the field. This is the screen that you would use to enter in that payroll information. So you'd select the employee, the job they're working on. If you happen to know the job code, you can type it in. What cost code it's going to go to, I'm going to say it's demo. And let's say that Larry worked on another job. We would just put that in right here. Whatever the cost code's for that job. You'll notice that we don't have demo set up on that job. So let's say that we're going to put that to concrete removal and so on. So very easy to enter time directly, or that could be imported from an external source. Once the time is in the system, the next step is you tell the system to process the payroll. That's where it's going to calculate all the pays, taxes, fringes, deductions. And then you can print the checks as well as do direct deposit and post. Let's say that you had to go in and edit a check because either an employee was late submitting some of their time, or maybe you had a last minute notification about a garnishment. And so you're going to go in and edit a check. So this is what the edit check screen looks like. So I'm going to just bring up an employee here. And you can see all of the pays, taxes, fringes, deductions here. So these are taxes, these are deductions, these are fringes. And this would be where we would go in and select In this case, we're going to do a one-time garnishment of $50 on this individual's check. You can also do manual layoff checks directly in the system too. Direct deposit is handled, as well as, and it's telling me I don't have some tax jurisdiction set up, but I'm just overriding it. All right, so we've done some costing with payables. We've done some costing with payroll. Let's go to the revenue side of things and let's talk about billing. So again, that can be done a couple different ways. I'm going to select this right here, AIA contract style invoices. And we're going to bring up the Office Park job. So what you see here is the schedule values that have been put together for the Office Park job. I haven't submitted the bill for this billing period. So we have, you can see here, we have some work completed this period that's been filled in. So as far as updating goes, you can update a percentage. You can type in the amount you're going to bill. And I want to make that an even 50%. You'll notice it recalculates the columns. Let's say on this item here, we're at 90%, and our contract lets us bill half the retainage. So we're going to update that. And then what you can do from here is that you could send a draft version to the customer to have them okay, a pencil copy, if you will, before you commit it in your AR and GL. Here's a copy of what that progress bill would look like to the customer. With regards to things like GL financial statements, again, lots of flexibility on that. The product comes with a financial statement designer that allows a lot of flexibility in how you build your balance sheet, P&L statements, cash flow statements. So you can look at those for current period or roll them back. So I'm going to just select this. You can see here I have multiple companies, so I can look at a consolidated statement or individual companies. If you have inventory, you can issue inventory to a job. If you have equipment that you own, you can also charge equipment time to a job. So that concludes our overview of Sage 300 CRE Timberline. If you have any questions, please get in touch. Click and subscribe. Thank you.